The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but underneath are ravenous wolves. By their fruits you will know them. Do people pick grapes from thorn bushes or figs from thistles? Just so, every good tree bears good fruit, and a rotten tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a rotten tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. So by their fruits you will know them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Pakibati din ng good morning ang ating mga katabi. Beautiful Wednesday morning. Batiin natin si Ate Mina ng happy birthday, yung ating lector. Happy birthday. Siya po ngayon ay 25 years old na. And it's also a sad day to our online parishioners. Thank you for being with us today also. But it's a sad day because very early this morning, I was awakened by a text from one of our devoted online parishioners, and she was telling me her daughter, Luan, that we have been praying for. I have mentioned her name several times already, and she passed on in Australia. And her mother, Corazon, is heartbroken because she could not go to her daughter. And so we pray for the repose of her soul, Luan Borhen. By their fruits, you will know them. Sa kanilang bunga, doon mo makikilala ang isang tao. Madali naman kasi yung mga paghahangad, pangarap, intention. Intentions are all good. Especially the well-meaning intentions, they are very good. We intend to do this, we intend to say that, we dream about this, we dream about that. The things that we have in our heart, even if they are passionate, the things that we have in our mind, even if they are so good, they would be nothing if they remain inside. They have to be seen and shown in our fruits. The fruits of the Spirit are what? Love, joy, kindness, patience, gentleness, self-control. These are the fruits of the Holy Spirit, and these are the manifestations of a holy life. By their fruits, you will know them. Madali pong sabihin na mahal natin ang isang tao, pero iba rin naman po ito pagka hindi nakikita sa ating mga ginagawa. Madali namang sabihin sa asawa na faithful ako sa iyo, pero kung ito'y hindi naman napapatunayan sa ating mga pang-araw-araw na buhay, parang hindi rin naman totoo. All good intentions go to nothing or waste or are wasted if they are not shown in our works. And that's basically the point of Saint Jose Maria Escriva. That's why I mentioned his name, because today is his feast day. Saint Jose Maria Escriva is an apostle of sanctifying your work. You don't have to be in the convent or be in the sanctuary all the time in order to be holy. Holiness can be found in our ordinary work. That's why he founded the group called Opus Dei. Opus means work, operatio, work of God, Opus Dei. Because he believes firmly that wherever you are, wherever you are planted, you could be a doctor, a lawyer, an engineer, a businessman, you could be a CEO or a janitor, whatever state of life you are in, That station of life is where you are called to be holy. That's how you express and where you express your holiness. Kung nasaan ka. Kung ikaw isang nanay na full-time na homemaker, then that is your path to holiness. And sabi ni Saint Jose Maria Escriva, the path to holiness is when we do everything for love. When everything we do is for love and coming from love, that's sanctifying our daily work. And I'm really grateful to all of you. At ako po'y galing lang sa Kuala Lumpur, and I gave a talk about evangelization. And I pinagmalaki ko po itong ating mga online parishioners at kayo din po. Kasi sinasabi ko sa kanila doon sa aking sharing, napakarami kong kwentong narinig. Of course, in English. English po, kaling tayo doon. So, nakakwento ko sa kanila na maraming nagkukwento sa akin ng mga online parishioners na on their way to work, nasa kotse sila, nagda-drive, o kaya sila ay nasa bahay, nagluluto. Of course, that's, in one way, you're saying, that's not respecting the mass. That is some sort of a disrespect to the sanctity and sacredness of the mass, because you are not paying attention very well, because you are driving, you are in the MRT or in the jeepney or taxi, and you are having this online mass. And some of them, yes, ask me about it. Isn't that a little bit odd and a little bit sacrilegious, to say the least, because you are having mass online and it's not a real mass, and it's a mass online and you're not really into it? But from my experience with our online parishioners, I told them, I cannot say for myself and judge whether the people online are being led to holiness and prayer by what we do. But many of them, they tell me, because of the online mass, they are led to prayer. Because of their daily attendance to an online mass, they are led to appreciate the Word of God. They are led closer to God. Yes, they don't go to mass at least on a daily basis, but they do on a Sunday. But in their daily work, as they go to work, yan, kinukwento ko po ito sa mga kausap ko. Kasi interesado sila sa nangyayari sa atin nung kinuwento ko ito. Ang gawain sa araw-araw ay pwede mong pabanalin kapag sinimulan mo sa panalangin. Ulitin ko po. Ang gawain sa araw-araw ay pwedeng pabanalin pag sinimulan sa panalangin. Hindi ka kailangang maging katulad ng mga Pink Sisters na 24/7 in front of the adoration or in front of the Blessed Sacrament. But it is more than enough that for you, an ordinary worker, you know, a rank and file or a CEO or whatnot, you'd begin your day with a prayer. You sanctify everything. At yun ang ginagawa ng ating mga online parishioners. They come with us 7 a.m. For others abroad at the end of their work. And then so they end and begin their day with a prayer with us in the Mass. That's your path to holiness. When on your way to work, you are praying. And as you work, you are also sanctifying it by way of prayerfulness and sharing love, generosity and kindness wherever you are. So Saint Jose Maria Escriva is on point when he said, we don't have to go inside a monastery to be sanctified. We don't have to go to the mountains or the seas in order to encounter God. Right there and then, where you are, whether you are driving or in the street or in your business, in your office, in your classroom, in your ward, or in the hospital, that's your place of holiness. And how do you make that place holy and full of God's presence? Love. Love will spell the difference between a fruitful and dying life or a dying person. As long as there is love that you pour out in everything that we do, as long as there is love in the way we relate and connect with others, then we become fruitful. The fruit of the Holy Spirit, the fruit of a holy life is always love, joy and patience, kindness and gentleness. So we do this every day. Every day, simulan natin sa panalangin. Kung araw-araw ang ating gawain ay sisimulan sa panalangin, ito ang ating daan patungo sa kabanalan. We ask Saint Jose Maria Escriva to intercede for us that we may sanctify our daily work and that we may find the presence of God everywhere we go and in everything that we do every day. Praised be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalo sa ating banal na misa. To our online parishioners, thank you for being with us also. Tomorrow ay simula na po ng ating Novena Masses. May I invite you to please join me in preparing for our fiesta. Hindi lang po ako, but all of us, let us prepare together. And tomorrow is our first Novena Mass. I will preside to start it off. But I'd like to invite you, especially way June 28, I believe, Cardinal Joe will be with us, no? Our Archbishop. Baka naman gusto nyo kong samahan dito, baka sabihin ni Cardinal, wala tayong ano rito, no? Parishioner, sasampu lang tayo dito, no? But may I invite you to help me welcome Cardinal Joe Advincula, our Archbishop, in his Novena Mass. Hindi siya makapagmimisa sa fiesta kasi ang mga bishops po natin ay nasa Cagayan de Oro for their General Assembly. Used to be dito sila sa Payos pag July, but this time they went to Cagayan de Oro. So we pray for them also. And other priests are invited for our Novena Masses. So we have Novena Mass at 7 a.m. and 12:15. So yung dalawa pong Novena Mass po tayo. And then sa fiesta natin, July 6, we'll follow the Sunday schedule. We spread it out para mas marami po tayong makadalo sa ating pagdiriwang. Again, we greet Ate Mina, happy birthday. Singilin nyo na lang ng breakfast mamaya. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.